He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Let's practice assessing atomic radii and ionic radii. The first question says, place the following elements in order of increasing atomic radius. So we have lead, germanium, krypton, fluorovium, and bromine. The second question says, place the following species in order of increasing ionic radius. So we have O2-, Mg2+, F-, Na+, and neon, a neutral neon atom. So if this seems confusing, go back and check out my tutorial on the periodic table and periodic trends. One of those trends is atomic radius, and we also talk about ionic radius. So that will give you the understanding you need to answer these questions. So first, let's do the atomic radius trend. We need to find these five elements on the periodic table. We've got lead, we've got germanium, we've got krypton, we've got fluorovium, and we've got bromine. So those are the five elements that we are looking at. So now we want to put them in order of increasing atomic radius. So what do we know about atomic radius? We know that atomic radius is going to increase as we go to the left. As we go to the left, there are fewer protons in each nucleus, and that means there is less of an electromagnetic attraction between the nucleus and the electrons. So the nucleus will not pull on the electrons as tightly as we move to the left. That means that the atoms will get slightly larger moving to the left on the periodic table. We also know that atomic radius increases going down on the periodic table, because each time we go down one period, we're adding an entire shell. And so that certainly is going to make the atom quite a bit larger by adding an entire new shell on the atom. So we know that atomic radius increases going left and down, and that means that if we start at krypton and go to the left, krypton must be smaller than bromine, and bromine must be smaller than germanium. Separately, going down this group, we know that germanium must be smaller than lead, and lead must be smaller than fluorovium. So now, this is actually quite easy. We can just combine these two trends because germanium is the biggest one in the first trend and the smallest one in the second trend. So let's just put them together, and the correct order in increasing atomic radius is krypton, bromine, germanium, lead, fluorovium. Now let's talk about ionic radius. Here we have some ions. Let's find them. We've got oxygen there. We've got magnesium there. We've got fluorine here. We've got sodium here. And we have neon here. So with ions, it's very important to know how many electrons are in each species. So looking at oxygen first, we know that a neutral oxygen atom has 8 electrons. For a neutral atom, the number of electrons is equal to its atomic number, right? Same number of protons and electrons. So neutral oxygen would have 8. But this is an O2- ion. That means there are 2 additional electrons, 2 additional negatively charged particles. So 8 plus 2 is 10. O2- has 10 electrons. Looking at Mg2+, a neutral magnesium atom has 12 electrons, but this is a 2+ ion, so it has 2 fewer negatively charged particles. It has lost 2 electrons, so Mg2+ also has 10 electrons. Neutral fluorine has 9 electrons, but this is F-, so it has gained 1 electron. F-, or the fluoride ion, also has 10 electrons. For sodium plus, neutral sodium normally has 11 electrons, but it has lost 1, so Na+ also has 10 electrons. And lastly, neon is neutral, so that will just have the same number of electrons as its atomic number, and that is 10. So that means these are all isoelectronic species. These all have the same number of electrons. and specifically, they all have neon electron configuration. Because they all have the same number of electrons, they are all going to experience the same amount of electron repulsion. So 10 electrons are going to push against each other and push outwards in the same way for all of these species. So the number of electrons is not a factor in determining this trend. Instead, the ionic radii are going to be determined by the number of protons in the nucleus. So they all have 10 electrons, but how many protons are pulling on those 10 electrons? The more protons there are in the nucleus, the more they will pull on the electrons and pull the electrons in towards the nucleus, which means the more the ionic radius will contract. So for isoelectronic species, the ionic radius will get smaller as we add more protons to the nucleus. That means that fewer protons will pull on the electrons less, and the ionic radius will expand. So as we take protons away from the nucleus, the ionic radius will increase. So in order to get this trend, we have to start with the species that has the most protons, because that is going to pull the electrons the most, and that is going to be Mg2+, because there are 12 protons in that nucleus, followed by Na+, which has 11 protons, neon has 10 protons, the fluoride ion has 9 protons, and the oxide ion has 8 protons. So fewer protons going to the right, that means less and less attraction between the nucleus and those electrons, so the ionic radius will expand as there are fewer protons in the nucleus, and this is the correct order to place these in increasing ionic radius.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.